Scorched side and caught fire yesterday afternoon. 12-year-old Jazmine Alfaro Villarreal died at the scene. Her family just devastated. Her grandmother telling us something absolutely heartbreaking today. Jazmine's 11-year-old sister was on that same bus in the back. She even saw Jazmine toward the front of the bus after the crash, but simply could not get to her as those flames spread. Maria Martinez spoke with us in Spanish about her grandbaby, Jazmine. My little girl was sweet and beautiful. She said, I can't believe this happened. She did not deserve to die like that. This family says they would like for school officials and police to be more forthcoming with answers, as they have not been so, according to this family. Coming up at 6, we're going to hear more from this family, learn more about Jazmine, who she was, what she dreamed of becoming when she grew up.
Parents were showing up to pick up their kids. Some had
October 3rd.
Others physically had ice bags pressed to their heads. The one thing they seemingly all had in common were stories of escape. It's a scene that 42 students will never forget. Moments of surprise followed by pure terror.
The bus started swerving left and right. And then, like, I flew out of my seat.
And then it slammed into a electric pole, and then it started getting, like, smoky and fiery.
Inside the bus, students say screaming and yelling gave way to a panicked escape as smoke began to pour in.
A stranger that I didn't know, a girl, she helped me unbuckle, and then I ran out to see.
Sixth grader Ramona Mitchell says it was another student who may have saved her life, but it was a different rescue attempt that was unsuccessful. Seventh grader Sergio Conaway says he will never forget.
My girlfriend was trying to save me.
His girlfriend, he says, was doing her best to free another student trapped in the bus as the smoke and flames got closer.
She couldn't because the bus driver had pulled her out, and the bus had caught on fire after.
It's hard, and I'm going to have to pray for her. I'm going to have to pray for her peace of mind.
Parents say they still can't believe it happened. The school bus ride, seemingly ordinary in every way, with an ending that was anything but.
I'm glad she's alive, but at this time she would not be riding the public school bus.
And some parents we spoke with say they're upset their kids were even brought here in the first place and not taken straight to the hospital. At least two parents told us they would be taking their kids straight from here to the emergency room.
And supplies mark the spot. Flowers and balloons sway along windy Lawson Road. The remnants of the school bus full of middle schoolers heading home Wednesday afternoon. Crash and fire claiming the life of 12-year-old Jazmine Alfaro Villarreal. At her family's home, unimaginable pain. Jasmine's grandmother, Maria Martinez, can only lean on family. I want to believe it's not her. She's not in that burnt bus. Jazmine's 11-year-old sister, Jaylene, sits still physically in shock, still asking her sister's whereabouts. The two were inseparable. They are sweet, loving girls. Jaylene was on the same bus. She saw Jazmine toward the front after the crash, but couldn't get to her as the flames grew. I can't believe this happened. She did not deserve to die like that. Jazmine, family say, wanted to be a chef like her grandma or an artist.
Yeah.
She was my little girl. She was so young. It's something you just